A woman speaks 20,000 words a day. Can you believe that?
Yes.
I still don't have an answer to all these questions that I have. But
sometimes it really amazes me to know even in today's time, this happens. But one thing that I've learned from my mother and from my grandmother, these are the two important people in my life who have made me understand what the true world is. Coming from a very protective world, a protective world, not that, you know, I was not allowed to do anything, a protective world where I was put among them always. Always surrounded with 12 brothers, played with my 12 brothers, always kept me or treated me equally among my 12 brothers. My 12 brothers involves my own and my cousin brothers. We all grew up together. I never understood this differentiation between men and women. And I feel this important thing that I learned, or my brothers have learned, is because of my grandmother. I give the entire credit to her because she has been very instrumental in raising all of us when our parents have been busy working. It really surprises me even today when I meet people when we are characterized. I really don't know what to say about it. When I was preparing for my presidential address, I thought I'd speak about someone very eminent. Somebody that I really look up to, one of the persons that I really look up to was Indrai Muni. But then I realized all this information is already available in the internet. Why not speak about my thoughts about this entire process of why women are discriminated or why we celebrate International Women's Day? Though sometimes still I question why do we celebrate this, probably because I'm not exposed to the other side of the world. Maybe I've just been too fortunate and blessed that I've been surrounded with a place where I've always been treated equal. I've always been, if I've ever fallen down, I've always had somebody to give me that strength. But yes, sadly it still does happen. Because very lately when I meet a lot of women, especially my help, who always keeps, you know, sharing the kind of sorrow, the discrimination that she has gone through in her life, really surprises me that why still do we have something like this when the world is grown so much? When we talk a lot about equal opportunities, for me, equal opportunities is not about treating women and men equally. Equal opportunities is about giving every human being, every individual equal opportunities. Give them a chance to grow. Give them a chance to show their potential. Just show a little bit of trust in that individual, and any individual can make a huge difference. If I have gained this perspective, the credit goes to the men in my life, the two most important men in my life. One who is my confidence, and one is my strength. My father is my confidence, and my brother is my strength. I know I have said this to a lot of people many times, how my brother plays a very instrumental role in my life. But yes, even till today, at times when I don't believe myself, I don't see myself that capable or able enough to do something, it is he who can push me, annoy me also, but push me to do what I think I was not able to and make me able to do that. I cannot imagine the person that I hated the most in my childhood is someone that I cannot imagine my life with today, because he has been my driving strength at the lowest point of my life and even at the best point of my life. He just knows how to keep me grounded. He just knows how to show the best of myself. The only request that I have to every individual here, I will not say only to the men, every individual over here, just show that confidence, that strength to your people around you that you're surrounded with. Just give that belief that you can do anything that you want to do. Trust me, that can create a huge difference. This very place is also very instrumental. I'll give the credit to the Bangalore Toastmasters Club, who very instrumentally build an individual to be the best version of themselves. So friends, the only message I would like to tell you all is, please give others an opportunity. Just be patient, trust them, and when the logical mind doesn't work, keep yourself calm, step back, and let your logical mind think a little more better. Do you really need to discriminate? Do you really want to take back someone's opportunity? Is that what, as an individual, you want to be in today's time, where everything is available? And for the people where things are not available, try and be that instrumental figure where you can make things available to them. With this, I will let you all give a thought about how do you want to take your life, or how you want to treat the people around you. I leave you all with this thought, and I would like to introduce you with someone who would be taking this meeting forward. A fighter, I really call this person a fighter. Anytime things do not work in her way, she knows how to turn that into her way. She is a theatrical artist, an amazing singer, a person always filled with energy and creativity. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming our Toastmaster of today's meeting, Toastmaster Varsha.
Anyways, happy anniversary. Now instantly he replied, telling Varsha, I'm not old enough to call 10 o'clock when you eat. And then I had to tell him that, so that's okay, but you're old enough to be married. And he instantly agreed. So I'm someone who loves to debate and, you know, pull legs. So I just wanted to prolong the conversation. I did ask, okay, so you acknowledge that you're old enough to, you know, marry me. Why don't I wish the other old spouse a very happy wedding anniversary? And he again replied to him, Asha, yes, I'm old enough, but I'm not old. And then I have to tell him that this is precisely why I'm scared to marry. Because people say that men are the head of the families, you know, it's a male-dominated world. So what do I do? I said, why are you scared? He should be scared. I completely agree with the fact that a man is the head of the family. I have it in my chat record. I put it on the PTMC group once we finish the meeting. He did tell that. He did tell this. He did make the statement that yes, undoubtedly, man is the head of the family. But you know what? Women are. They are the neck which turns the head in the direction. So that is our theme for today. And this reminds me, maybe it's a coincidence. One of the role takers today sent out a beautiful short story which even I was inspired with. And today it came back to me very strangely. I was thinking about talking about the same. So a very famous, renowned, powerful, strong couple went on a boat trip. They had to pause for a while, and when they halted, they went to a remarkable restaurant. So the food was good. Husband is enjoying, and turns out to be that it was wife's ex-boyfriend's restaurant. Now, slyly, the husband says, what an unfortunate thing, you missed out an opportunity to become the owner of this restaurant. Now, men are men. You think the wife was quiet, just listening to the statement? No, she comes back with a witty reply, very wisely, that it's the other way around. You know, had I married him, he'd have been the president of the United States. So I'm sure you guys would have guessed which story that I'm referring to.
Michelle Obama.
Yes, I draw a lot of inspiration from her. So women are celebrated in very smallest way, very widely, across borders, and in her own way, she brings grace and elegance. So this wonderful fraternity, likewise, brings in a lot of grace and elegance into many people's lives, because it builds confidence. We talk about Toastmasters moment every time a Toastmaster of the day comes. There is a prepared speech there. It started in 1924, Santa Ana, California, from YMCA to Toastmasters moment. There are about 3 lakh members. There are about 16,000 clubs, 150 countries almost. So apart from that, I've seen many energetic leaders in Toastmasters fraternity, including many of them present in the hall today. So a typical Toastmasters meeting has 3 segments. The first segment is referred to prepared speeches. I relate this to a beautiful feature of a woman which goes as beauty and elegance. I relate this to beauty and elegance because people do a lot of efforts, do a lot of homework before they come onto the stage, before they present themselves. Next segment is very interesting and exciting segment. Now I want to call this as constructive segment and creative segment. So that is something that calls for something for people to think on their toes, that is table topics. And finally, there is, I also refer to this aspect of feature of, you know, women, which is constructive and most importantly, yet constructive yet sensitive. So that segment is referred to as evaluation segment. So it is important for us to grow, hence evaluations are must. So to lead that segment for today, we have someone with us who holds many firsts, but what I like about her the most is the competitive spirit. Every time with and she marks her speeches, and these are mostly landmark speeches that we need to record. So let's put our hands together for Toastmaster Sumitra Manmohan.
Feedback, they say, is breakfast for champions. And we in Toastmasters strongly believe in it because we believe in continuous improvement. A very good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and happy Women's Day. My role today as general evaluator is to give to observe the entire proceedings of the meeting, give feedback as to what went well, what could have gone better with some solutions, and helping me, apart from the three individual evaluators for the speakers, I also have a team that's called the TAC team, the trio, that's going to support me. The first one is, if you want to stand out as a professional, you have to be able to keep time in your control. And for that, we have a person whose field of study is biochemistry and zoology. So if you, she will ensure that you don't go wild with the way you use time. And she will keep track of the time that you lose. And she is the time manager, and the donning that role is Shreya Sadhupal, and she will explain her role in more detail. Let's welcome. With PepsiCo, and today she is going to help you manage your non-words like ah, oh, hum. And to tell you more about her role, let's welcome the R counter, Himani Pandey.
Good evening, everyone. As an R counter, I will be listening very carefully for the use of vocal pauses and crutch words, such as air, you know, and repetitive words and phrases. I'll be keeping track of everyone and give my report at the end of the meeting who best control their repetitive words and all the crutch words and filler words. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Now the next person who's going to come and explain her role. When I think of her, I can only think of profusion. Profusion in our hospitality and showering us with the yummies, and she also profusely will praise you and appreciate you. She's also a counselor, so today she is going to counsel you on how to use your language. So let us call our grammarian, Toastmaster Surekha, to explain her role in more detail. for the good and not so good usages of the English language. So the word of the day today is muliebrity, which means feminine nature or womanly qualities. A good sentence usage would be, she embraced her muliebrity with strength and confidence. So speakers, with every sentence you have the chance to turn your speech into a little grammar dance. Thank you.
Today. There are also four
my three sisters. Growing up together was so much fun. During the day, we would chase butterflies and dragonflies, climb trees, collect fruits, mangoes, guavas, peaches, apples, fill our pockets and our school bags too. Sit under a tree and enjoy the fruits of our labor. Another favorite thing was to catch fireflies and free them in our mosquito nets. Watching them, we would fall asleep. Growing up, we were India Trotters, but now we are a true Globetrotter family. My brother stays in Canada. Two of my sisters are in Europe, and the other two, including me, are in India. I also stayed in the US when I was working. I started working pretty early when I was doing my graduation in science. In the morning, I would attend my college, and in the evening, I would teach kids my favorite subject, math. After college, I worked for a few places before joining the booming IT BPO industry. This industry did not just give me a successful and a vibrant career, but also my life partner. My husband Pushkar was my boss. But now you know who is the boss. The king may rule the world, but it's the queen who moves the board. Once I found the king of my life, I mean the love of my life, I decided to follow another love of mine, art. I left my job and joined Srishti College in Bangalore to do my postgraduate in the arts. After Srishti, I worked with artist Sudarshan Shetty in Bombay. Currently, Pushkar and I are working on another passion of ours, food. We both are coming together with a startup, Conscious Wellness Global, that is going to provide healthy food options to the health conscious. Dear Toastmasters and my fellow travelers, my name is Amrit, that means nectar. And true to my name, I wish to spread nectar through my food that fills the body and through my art that fills the soul.
Level 1 Project 2 from the Pathway Dynamic Leadership The purpose of the project is to learn or review basic methods of writing a speech with a defined purpose and to present a well-organized speech on any topic. The speech length is 5 to 7 minutes. All the best to the speaker, and over to you.
Thank you so much. I'd like to apologize to the audience because I misread the profession. So anyway, Naina Alex is into data science, so she had a very puzzled look as my data was wrong. Naina Alex is data scientist by profession. But now we have an organized operations executive from ITC in our speaker, second speaker. Let's please put our hands together to Toastmaster Vasavi. Toastmaster Vasavi, Control plus R. Control plus R, Toastmaster Vasavi.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests.
Good evening.
We have a lot of beautiful ladies gathered here on this evening. I would like to ask a question to you. When was the last time you went on a solo date, had a scrumptious meal, and devoured every bit of it? Second, when was the last time you went on a movie alone and then ditched everybody, your so-called commitments, and felt happy about it? Yeah? Third, when was the last time you finally took out time to catch up with your old school friends and had a bicker and banter and laugh it off together?
Yes.
So, while you think about it, I would like to share with you stories of three women, Jaya, Anu, and Shri. Let me take you back in time. Assuming it is 30th June 1980. It is a bright sunny morning in the month of June. Jaya, along with her friends Rani and Sudha, were sitting under a tree, chatting about their day and then enjoying a scrumptious Alfonso mango. Suddenly came a voice. "Jaya, Jaya," the class monitor came. "The class teacher is looking out for you," said the class monitor. She immediately rushed to meet with the class teacher. The teacher called her and said, "Jaya, you have an emergency from your home. Your father had called for you," said the teacher. So many thoughts rushing into her head, she immediately went home. As soon as she entered her home, she saw her father standing right outside the door. She went to him and hugged him tight. Her father told her, "Jaya, go inside and get ready quickly. You have a suitor coming to see you today." She felt shocked. "But Appa, I am still studying. I am good at mathematics. My teacher told that I could become a mathematician like Shakuntala Devi someday," she retorted. Her father said, "That's all for later, but now you go inside and get ready." Without having a choice, she quit. Cut to 1st July 2000. "Anu, get ready quickly. I'll drop you off to your office and then I'll go to my office," said Hari. As soon as they were getting ready and about to exit the apartment, they heard a wild wail and a loud cry. "Oh no," said Hari. She started to cry again. And then he turned to Anu and asked her, "Anu, you know how important it is for me, right? I cannot afford to skip work today. I have a very important work meeting. Can you please stay back today and look after her daughter?" He pleaded to her with puppy eyes. She knew it. This is not the first time. She had been going through this for quite some time now, and it is the second time in a week this is happening. Without knowing that she had no choice, she said, "Okay, I'll do it for today, but somehow we have to figure a way out," she said. He immediately hugged her tight and left for work. Few days passed and the trend continued. Her manager called her and said, "Anu, I understand you recently had a baby and we are trying the best to support you. But you know, this can't go on like this because the others might think that we are favoring you much," said the manager. She dreaded She knew this day was coming. The same evening, with so many thoughts puddled in her head, she went home and she mustered up the courage to talk to Hari about it. While they were sitting at the dinner table, she told him, "Hari, I have something important to talk to you." She said, "Go on, I'm listening," he said. "Hari, you know what happened today at work? My manager said that I can't go on like this. You know that we have been doing this for quite some time and I am doing a lot of adjustment to make sure, you know, our family stays together," she said. The spoon in his hand fell off the plate. After a long pause, Hari said, "Anu, you know that I recently got promoted. And you very well know if I show a slack at this point of time, what will the management think of me? I can't afford to miss this chance to climb up the ladder. I am the next in line for the VP of the team. And we are earning quite well right now. Even if you quit, we will be able to take care of the family," he insisted. She mentally resigned that day. She once thought of the very famous lines of the song, "I spent all of the love I saved. We were always a losing game."
Basic research methods and present a well-organized
well-researched speech on any topic. Timer, please note, the speech length is 5 to 7 minutes. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Chair. The final speaker, I think probably when we talk about again one of the characteristics of women, she's someone who helps in transformation. And there's a very famous saying which goes this way: if a woman learns, community around her learns. So she is a person who's who's responsible, and by default, she's someone who can transform people. Now, the third speaker is a teacher by profession. And she is here to attempt her Level 1 Project 3. Let's put our hands together for Toastmaster Smita Roshi.
You're a lady.
What's the first thing, and how will you feel the rest of the day?
Women's Day experience being a woman, how will I deal with this male-dominated society? That is my first worry. Will I get the freedom? Will I continue to get the freedom and independence that I have been enjoying all these days? Obviously no, isn't it? Obviously no. Is there one man here, person here, who's not male chauvinist? Is there one person? Sure? The rest are male chauvinists, right? So you will feel that you're dominant and I am submissive. So I have no freedom. What will I do? Scream, yell, shout, feel frustrated? Is that what all women are doing? No. There are many women who have found a way to get around that and be successful, isn't it? Why is that? Because they felt that male chauvinism is a reality. Just like anger is a bad thing, but we all get angry and because it exists in nature. Same way, male chauvinism exists in nature. It comes as a part of our evolution. Human beings evolved. First, they were hunter-gatherers. Then they were farming. Both these professions were masculinity-driven, driven by, you know, physical strength. And so men dominated. Okay, this has got into the DNA for thousands of years. So they are going to be like that for few thousand years. Therefore, we have to put up with it, accept that as a reality, get around them and figure out my freedom and move forward and become one of those Indira Gandhis or Kiran Mazumdar Shah or Narayan Sudha Murthy. Thank you.
Your waking up as a woman. Our next topic goes to Toastmaster Abhay. Can we have him here?
Did not have money to register that house. It had become a gift. But I said that I'll help. Please send your person. I listened to that person, contacted the subordinates. At that time I was working as a law student in the government.
I requested that person to come to the next day, and I request the representative of this person to be there at 9:30 next day. I went to my office at 9:30. The officer was there, but this representative was not there. We waited from 9:30 to 12, and at 12 that person was about to go. Then this representative came inside, rushing, shivering. What happened? Why are you late? Then he told me, sir, I came at 9 o'clock. In front of your office, there was a man starving, falling down. I took him to my house, gave him food, looked after. What happened? He died. The person was Mother Teresa. Yeah. Later on, her work was done. I think it was a miracle. The property was registered. Then she sent me one card. Just one card with a signature. Sign. Thank you, Mother Teresa. That's a perfect.
Mother Teresa has inspired all of us for her tireless work until her last breath. The next topic. So, women are considered doing all the household chores. So, what is that one household chore she's ready to give up? What is your take, Toastmaster Vishal?
My son's God.
my kitchen to be clean. I love my kitchen to look tidy. And I love my house to be simple. Can you do it?
Come on. I promise everything which you have told me. I came to your house after learning about you, after the promises which your son had made. So I might not be the king in the house, but I will be a queen who can manage your son. Today he might be waking up at 10 o'clock, but tomorrow, after, I mean, it's not tomorrow, after 1 month or so, he will be forced to do so. You know, the way we can do that. Not only he would wake up at 7 o'clock, but he would also cook food. That's the minimum requirement in my house. Like, every time my father wakes up, he would be waking up earlier than my mom. And she would at least make a tea for her. So, tea for her. So that is the minimum requirement I have also from the service.
Expects a lot. they have all kinds of urges to eat something different, to visit different places. So just put yourself in the man with the shoes, the poor man. Suddenly at 11 o'clock in the night, midnight, I want to eat pani puri. Come on, get real. We have restaurants that work till midnight, perhaps 1 a.m. But pani puri, are you kidding? That's ridiculous. Another fancy, suddenly they feel, I want to wear some dress. At 2 a.m., I feel like wearing the dress. Now, which store on earth is open at 2 a.m.? You can't even order online. I mean, even if you order online, you can't get it at 12. So it's difficult. Ladies, I know women, they don't get me wrong. You see that in the topic? It's extremely challenging for a man who is married to a lady and his wife is carrying. It's extremely challenging. Not only that, suddenly health takes a beating and he has to take her to the hospital. Now he's doing everything possible to comfort her. Why can't you drive slowly? I mean, you have to get to the hospital fast. And the lady shouts, can't you drive properly? It is so tough. So what I'm going to say, ladies, I know that we men can't bear children. But all I'm saying, bear with the child in us.
Imagine and you went ahead and did multitasking, but you I see it day in, day out, how my wife, my mother, and my sister as well out there in the street, how they juggle with so many things at same time. And my wife is a working lady, gets up at 5 o'clock, cooks food for all of us, sends our daughter, and it's been what now? 8 years, and not even one day my daughter has missed her school bus. I don't know how else can, how she does it. It's like every early morning is like a airport at our house. One flight leaves at 8 o'clock, 8:30, 9 o'clock. But without losing her sense of balance, she manages it. So has my mother done for all these years. So I don't know how God has gifted women with this abundance of this multitasking skill. And the way they treat us, the way they take care of, I think words will not do justice to express our gratitude. So I don't think they fail. They are super successful. That's my question.
I have so many instances of trying to do the multitask that women are good at. There are a lot of multitasks that men are good at, but women are good at. I remember I was 9. And it so happened that all the women ended up aligning their period cycles. So all of them were out of the kitchen. And I was the only guy left and I had to cook. So here I was with 3 ladies at the entrance of the kitchen trying to tell me how to cook. Now I knew how to make rice. So I somehow stumbled through and I was able to make the rice. But I didn't know how to take the water out of the rice bowl. So I had to figure a knack out. While I was doing that, I also had to make the dal and do the tadka. So I remember putting the oil and the karadevu. And I took like a minute more to pour the water out of the rice and the karadevu became black and I got scared and I put that in. So I had to start over again, clean it up and then restart making the dal, doing the tadka and everything. I remember making that day dal, chawal, roti. It took me easily like 3.5 hours and I had to categorize it and then do it properly. And I was like, oh my god, this is so complicated. But on the reverse side, I see my sister trying to drive a car and I see she takes everything categorically, turning the car on, getting in, putting the seat belt, and then slowly changing things and then moving ahead. And for me, I've done everything in like the first millisecond. I have the seat belt on, I have the car on, it's halfway through the road and the gear has all moved naturally. So I think men and women both multitask brilliantly in different categories, in different contexts. So I wouldn't just give the credit to women, I think we men also deserve a round of applause.
Toastmaster Brian and Toastmaster Akash.
about my mother. I would take like 7-8 minutes to speak about her, because I, you know, you can't describe what she has done for me. She was a school teacher before I was born, and just for my sake, she resigned from her post as a school teacher, just so that she could take care of me, and you know, she could feed me and all that stuff. And even then, later, she wanted to go back into the field, become a teacher again. But again, you know, she was worried about me. And her mother, you know, mothers and fathers, they're a bit different, because mothers, they have that thing sometimes, you know, in their heart that, you know, my child, I can't be even 1 minute without spending time with them. So my mother, even at the end, when she got the chance, when I grew up to go back and become a teacher, she told, no, I don't want to do it. I'll be with Akash. I'll take care of him. So that's all I can say.
Mother is easily the most controversial in the house. Today I was in a call with Priyanka in the afternoon, and it's about 11 a.m. and I had not eaten the breakfast. I was on a call with Priyanka and I told mother, call. Like, what call? You didn't have a breakfast yet. I was like, and I put myself on mute. I don't think she knows that, but I put myself on mute, and then after the call, she made me hot, nice, brown, crispy dosas with butter, and I had. Similarly, yesterday, she was telling that a friend of, a relative of ours passed away, and she told, Brian, life is so short. We should spend our every second in the fullest. Have what we want. Watch movies with me, like, and I told her, mother, let's bring chicken roll, and say no. what do you mean? And that's my mother.
We can't speak about her in a minute. They are dominating, but we love them. The next topic is a little serious. I'd like to know that there is diversity being introduced in a lot of corporate organizations, right? Especially in Accenture, it's about 50-50 in a certain time period. I'd like to know whether you agree, distinguished Toastmaster Gangadhar.
Since time immemorial, women have always been some taking a kind of a backstage. So men have taken the front stage. So it's not that, you know, women have been put there. It's the way the balance has worked. And I feel today, if women are coming forward, it's great, it's lovely, and we need to encourage that, because we get a variety when we do that. We get the creativity, we get the patience, we get the persistence, we get so many things that a woman is more. Her qualities, liberty, as against man, rash, angry, whatever. So yes, I agree with that. Right.
Toastmaster Srinivas.
Good evening, Toastmasters and my dear guests.
Good evening.
Good evening, public masters. So, Umar Ambar comment is everywhere, and even in our Toastmasters school, especially Bangalore Toastmasters, having more than 50% as women in our list as a Toastmasters. Every time we give a chance to male and female equally, even in our Toastmasters also, especially our president, Priyata Narare, is a woman, and today is a Women's Day, what we are celebrating here. And in the, before we started our meeting, I have been discussing with Toastmaster Sri Lakshmi also, and she's saying, today I'll be giving table topics only to the male because they're supposed to get a chance. They're supposed to get a chance. So this is a take they're giving to us, not a male nominations. Over to you.
Things need to be done in a systematic way. It's not just we completed, but with the checkboxes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So sometimes I try to be like my previous version, like I will do it my way, but now that's not possible, and we encountered a lot on that, to be agree and sometimes disagree. So yeah, that's one of things, but what I felt after being to reporting to her, is like sometimes it's good to be work in organized way and know the numbers, know the things, how it should be done, rather than it should be done just the same way. Thank you.
That was our last table topic speaker. Fellow Toastmasters and dear guests, what did you take, especially the guests, why was this beneficial? One, it's preparing you to speak impromptu. Now imagine you are caught in the lift with your CEO or your boss. It helps you speak faster. Now you're going to see a girl or a guy. It's your wedding proposal. It keeps you prepared, want to speak faster. Well, the list goes on, but I'd like to thank our Vice President Education and our Madam President and the XCOM team for giving me an opportunity to be your table topic master this evening. And I now hand over to Madam Toastmaster. Thank you, Toastmaster Sri Lakshmi. I'm sure you've made each one of us think with every topic that you gave. I was wondering how would it be like to wake up as a man and pay 200 rupees to cops, and how would I even ensure, let's say I have a future kid, how would I ensure that things go smoothly, like how Ganesh Pai's wife is running the show at their place, while I myself have bunked at least 70-80% of the classes. So it was a good breakfast or lunch or dinner, whatever you call it as. It was definitely a food for thought for all of us. Thanks once again for those enthralling topics. Let's give him again. Final segment. Like I said, it's of course constructive. It is at the same time very sensitive because it helps in a person's growth. Now,
sensitivity is something that you can refer to one of the characteristics of a woman again. Now, this Toastmaster that I'm calling upon, I've already given her introduction earlier, but I'm having the privilege to introduce her all over again, because what we do not know about her is that, you know, she's a very, very caring and nurturing mother. When I asked her what made you feel that the life is worth it to be a woman, she instantly came up with this statement telling that when she first held her firstborn child, she felt that it was worth it. To a yes, okay, there's one other.
That was my.
No, she is. So it's very important for us to, you know, nurture that, and you know, as a godmother for Toastmasters fraternity, she's here to lead our evaluation segment. Let's put our hands together to DTM Sumitra Manmohan.
Women are always critical, I guess. Never happy with what you all do. But today I'll be, you know, nurturing and caring. So we took off well exactly at 6:30 today, didn't we?
Yes.
Yeah. And what a wonderful burst of energy we had here with Shreya. You know? She not only is the timer for today, she's also the sergeant at arms. For a moment, I was wondering whether you are Shreya, you know, taking up two roles. Hats off to you. And you were full of energy. What I liked, you had a bit of humor. And the way you brought in the, you know, the housekeeping thing that, you know, to switch off the phone because the women likes full attention and all that. Very creatively you brought it. Keep it up. Keep it up. Yeah? And I don't have anything, you know, things for improving. Just go on at the same. Maybe you can slow down your pace of talking. But I can understand the enthusiasm. So let's give Shreya a thunderous applause. Shreya gave us such a wonderful introduction. You forgot to embrace. saved her. So please keep that in mind. And then coming on to the Toastmaster of the day, she is full of energy. Yeah, full of energy, and I like the way you started off with a song and a lot of humor. And what I liked was that, you know, when the icebreaker was there, she was running off the stage, but you pulled her back and let her take all the appreciation. You also had humor, and when you wandered up the introduction, very nicely, humorously, you covered it up. So my suggestion is, do a little more preparation and try and speak to the role takers. I'm sure you'll get something more interesting. Because when you speak, it will record in your mind and you won't have to get muddled. But a little more effort, definitely you'll be brilliant, you'll dazzle the crowd. Yeah, with that, well done, Varsha. Or let's give the president and Varsha a good round. Speeches. Our first speaker was Amrit, and her evaluator was the ever enthusiastic Rashi.
A very good evening once again to dear Toastmasters guests and the speaker in particular. I think the two main purpose or the objectives of the speech was for her to break the ice to the members of the club that and the basic structure of the speech. And I think you've done that really well. Some of the points that she excelled at while giving her speech, the first one was the structure of the speech. So she gave a very chronological order about her journey from where she was born to her family, her job, and her present stage where she's standing now. The second point was the hand gestures that she used. So during several parts of her speech, when she was talking about her mother giving her the protectiveness or the confidence, where she spoke about her siblings and several other areas. The third point is the subtle humor that she added here and there, which made the audience laugh and instantly just kind of connect with you. So that brought out a really nice added feature to your speech. And if I may, I have two suggestions. The first one was the stage usage. I know it's too early on, but maybe, so you were centrally located. Maybe when you were talking about the chronology of your life, you could have used different parts of the speech, different parts of the stage. And the second one was the voice. So I think it was a little too soft for the audience to hear at the back. Maybe if you could just volume it up a little bit. And the conclusion, I must say it was so beautiful where you said your name, brought out the meaning of your name, and with that you explained the purpose of your life. So that was something that I really enjoyed. And this completed your speech in such a beautiful way. The last conclusion that I have is you've completed the speech flawlessly, delivered it with the grace of nectar that sweetened the audience's experience. So congratulations.
Thank you, Rashi, for that great feedback and very well put. Yeah. Maybe at some points you were talking of she make her inclusive, because this feedback is giving to the person who's spoken. So ensure that, you know, she is also involved. Yeah. We go on to the next speaker, who was Vasvi Hariharan, and she was evaluated by Naina Alex. Can you please have your feedback?
Relevant and eye-opening is how I would describe Toastmaster Vasvi's speech. A reality check is what she has given us by giving us three stories of three different eras. Of Jaya from her grandmother's era, of Arun from her mother's era, and Shri from RM. It was clear that she was trying to tell us the reality that we often miss. And she concluded her speech very beautifully with a quote that we are not the ashes of a cigar, but the stardust that makes galaxies. It's such a beautiful quote because it has so many layers to it. You go from a stardust to a star that makes a galaxy so sparkly. So if I could help transition Vasavi from a stardust to a star, here's how I would do it. When you talked about Jaya's story, and you said so many thoughts running through her head. Had you said like, so many thoughts running through her head, with a little more movement, a little more modulation, and a little more eye contact with the audience, it would have just transitioned you from stardust to a star. Overall, I think that Vasavi's speech had us at the edge of our seats, had us engaged and agreeing with her because we realize that this is a reality that exists, but we often miss. All the best, Toastmaster Vasavi.
Thank you, Naina, for that very incisive and encouraging feedback. Our third speaker, Smita Roshi, and she was evaluated by Chaitra.
Did it very well because of your delivery and also because of how You've brought out your emotions very well. I hope, I wish you all the best for your next speech.
Password is 3141.
stage work, and I thank Joe for our VP education for equipping us with all the profiles and all the details of the speech. Do you agree with me, Varsha?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Meticulously done. I think this was the first time we got the details of the project, the speech title and everything, which really helped us, you know, perform our role. So let's give Joe Spall and the rest of the committee a good round. We appreciate that initiative of giving, you know, starting that series of favorite book where Ganesh Bhai shared his favorite book on the war, and we hope we get many more, reviews from our Toastmaster members, and keep up the good work and very well organized. I think after a long time we had an all women's meeting, and as I've always said, I look forward to a committee entirely of you can give us a chance with just 6 months, don't worry. Right? And today we appreciate everyone differently. Okay, not by clapping, but we are going to laugh. But we are going to laugh with a gesture. Both hands. So let's start laughing in appreciation for all the members, because all are equal.
Newsletter reflection.
Sureta ma'am, and Toastmaster Jayashree Iyengar to join us in unwrapping. I'm very happy to say that Toastmaster Jayashree Iyengar has joined us after a very long time. But they say, right, men are also equally important, and I would like to call, invite our founder to please join us on the stage. The best auxiliary role taker for today's meeting goes to our grammarian Toastmaster. Thank you.
Yeah.